And welcome to Afternoons on 11. I am your host, Christine Buck. I'm in for April Simpson. So there are two women, two incredible stories of survival. Meet Beverly and Raylene, two of 11's inspirations.
It's a moment I will never forget. She said to me, Beverly, okay. I am so sorry. You have
brought
cancer.
Come out to us.
BRCA2 positive, just like Angelina Jolie, and a heart-wrenching diagnosis of stage 3 breast cancer. Beverly McGee knew she was in for a fight.
Implants make me shiver because implants are the reason why I was diagnosed with cancer for the second time.
Raylene Halra, a survivor in the struggle again. Cancer caused by breast implants, a diagnosis a lot of women are unaware of. Both women delivering a message of hope and support, offering their unique insight into dealing with breast cancer.
I feel like I've been given a new lease on life, and I really feel like I'm ready to take on the world.
I'm lucky enough to be here today, and I know my purpose is to make sure that education is out there, hope and courage, and I don't want anybody else to have to go through what I went through.
How they are using their life experiences to inspire others and save lives.
And welcome, Raylene. Hi, how are you doing?
I'm wonderful, it's great to be here.
Well, it's great to see you here. You know, like every other woman or man or anyone, when you get a diagnosis of cancer, I'm certain that you remember where you were, what was happening, that feeling of despair. Tell us about your story, starting with the first round.
The first round, I was 33 years old, and I went to my annual checkup. And I think it's important for everybody to go to an annual checkup because my breast cancer was at 33 and I had no family history whatsoever, and it was found on a clinical breast exam. And my wonderful doctor at St. Luke's, I feel like he was a part of saving my life.
When you say a clinical breast exam, you mean what?
That
just
means
a regular,
yes,
regular doctor
visit.
Feeling for any lumps or any things that felt abnormal.
Yes, and I did not feel it. He felt it and sent me on, and I found out I had stage 2 breast cancer.
Okay, so then what happened?
So then I chose, along with the support of my husband and my family and my friends and also my faith, I chose to do a double mastectomy without immediate reconstruction, followed by chemotherapy and then several more surgeries. And after about a year, I decided to do reconstruction.
And you were a little bit on the fence about it. It wasn't something that you were, as you said, rushing to do or that you felt really compelled to do?
Yes, I was ready. My husband always says the only thing I see missing is cancer, because even though I was young, getting rid of the cancer was most important for me.
Right.
So I did choose. I went to 3 different doctors, and when I met Dr. Nathan, I knew he was the one.
Okay, so you have reconstruction.
I have reconstruction. Things went well. I went to my regular oncology appointments every 4 months. I went to my plastic surgeon as follow-up for the post 3 years, and I was sitting in May, 5 years out from reconstruction, about ready to turn 40, and my right chest wall started swelling very quickly.
And so you knew that there was something wrong. I mean, that just that red flag. It's time to call the doctor.
And being a breast cancer patient, you got to remember
take diligent. You're always wondering.
Always.
I'm sure there's never that sense of peace and calmness. You know, and then when something like that happens, it's probably very exaggerated as well, too.
Exactly.
So you call the doctor.
Call the doctor. Went in for a CT scan. My regular plastic surgeon was on vacation for 2 weeks. They did a CT, biopsies, they said everything's fine, probably a bad implant. And they told me normally an implant will last 10 years. So I went in on my 40th birthday and I had surgery for an implant exchange. Everything went wonderful. And 10 days later, we came into the doctor's office. I had my children, my husband, and we're ready to get the drains out. And I was told I had non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, anaplastic large cell lymphoma, and it was 100% from my breast implant.
Yeah, because in the 2011, mm-hmm. the FDA came out with a warning saying that there is a link to this type of cancer. Now, the cancer is extremely rare. You're what, 25 cases?
I was case number 25 in the United States, number 61 in the world.
Wow.
And I was diagnosed on June 21st, and on June 23rd, I was already in Houston, Texas at MD Anderson because they had consulted or treated 19 out of those cases. So I knew I was at the right spot.
Mm-hmm.
I've worked with 50 doctors from the FDA now, 17 doctors down at MD Anderson, And since my case was diagnosed with the FDA, there's 50 new cases that they're working on.
Oh, okay. So they do since 2011 when they put that.
No,
warning.
Since my diagnosis in June, there's 50 new cases at the FDA.
In June of?
Of this year.
Oh.
So they know, I think it's more, the FDA stance is they regulate medical devices, they don't regulate doctors. So a lot of the plastic surgeons aren't aware that there could be a lymphoma problem. I was lucky enough to go to a wonderful doctor that knew about it and tested for it since I did have the late onset swelling.
And you're talking about, it doesn't matter what sort of implant.
No, saline, silicone, breast reconstruction, breast augmentation. The youngest woman to pass away from this was 21 years old, and she had breast augmentation at 18. And there was also a 26-year-old breast cancer survivor that had implants for 26 years, discovered she had the lymphoma, and she did pass away too.
So when you read about this and you look it up, it'll say that it's a very rare but treatable cancer.
Yes.
And that is if, in fact, it doesn't get into your lymph nodes.
It's totally. I knew
so
right
now in your case.
My case, it was all contained within the scar tissue. I was lucky enough to just do surgery. They were first talking that I was going to be down there for a year, chop chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery, but I was lucky enough. It was all contained and very treatable.
Okay, so now you really do feel like you're on a mission.
Totally. I woke up 5 weeks from being at home, and I know that this is my second cancer at the age of 40, and I love what I do. I'm lucky enough to have a wonderful career, but there was no doubt in my mind that I want to make a difference. I want to make sure that every woman has knowledge about this. When you get a recall on a vehicle, you get 3 notices in the mail. I even get a phone call from my local dealership. I want to make sure that every woman that's getting breast augmentation or reconstruction at least knows about it.
And let's take a look at the really special people here in the audience with you today. And those are just a few of the people who have been your support group.
Yes.
Through all of this ordeal. Not
Right.
the first, only the first time, but the second time around. And it has to be scary because it's not just you getting this diagnosis. It's a family event. I mean, everybody who loves you is affected.
Definitely. I have my daughter, Allison, who was only 3 when I was diagnosed with breast cancer, and my son that we're in the process of adopting. His mother passed away from cancer when he was 5, and then stepfather got cancer when he was in the 5th grade. We've been lucky enough to raise him for 2 years. And my best friend, Elaine, we met, we were diagnosed at the same time, and we met a year later, and we have just become wonderful friends.
That's wonderful, because of obviously you have a lot that you share. Now,
yes.
When you talk about wanting women to have this conversation with your doctors, you don't want to scare people.
Not at
you
all.
You just want to say that, hey, it may be rare, it may be treatable, but you need to talk to your doctor about implants so that you really do know that there is this possibility.
Definitely.
Very
My
rare.
Whole mission is early detection of breast cancer, going to your doctor, the dangers of implants, and knowledge is power, and then also rising up. When bad things happen to you, rise up and try to be positive.
Okay.
And I forgot to give kudos to my husband, who's not here today. I have a loving husband
oh,
of 20
knows
years.
It.
He knows.
He's fine. We'll talk some more when we come back, and we want to know what you have to say. You can leave your comments on our Facebook page. Go to KPLR11 Facebook page. And when we come back, she calls herself the breast warrior. I love that, how Beverly McKee is using her life experience to help others as well. We'll be right back. Stay with us. That's good.